All right, so we're gonna start Watercolor Wednesday Live all over again, an hour late. We did try to go on at 10 o'clock on YouTube and it just wasn't working, so welcome everybody. Hopefully everybody can migrate over to Periscope. Like I said, or tried to say on YouTube, lately I've had a black technology thumb, so it's very possible it's something I did. I don't know. Could be YouTube, could be my camera. I have no idea. So, I'm gonna have to have the husband look at it when he gets home. I don't know. All right, so we are working on swatching Grumbacher, Sennelier, and Coy this morning for our swatch book. Grumbacher was very nice enough to send me 6 tubes of paint, and Bismuth Yellow, Cadmium Orange, True Red, Sap Green, Prussian Blue, and Dioxazine Purple. Sennelier also sent a yellow, a red, and a blue, Yellow Light, Opera Rose, and Cinerus Blue. And then I have some Koi paints, so we swatched those too and added them to the other ones. I will later on add all of these to the Watercolor Wednesday download pictures. I'll scan everything and I'll put the links to the manufacturer's website on the Watercolor Wednesday page on my website. Hopefully all of you that were on YouTube can migrate over, I hope. I don't know what the deal was with YouTube this morning. Okay, when the camera went down, I started my comparative paintings, and I had just finished what was probably the last little bit on the Grumbacher one and was going to start the next one, and the computer, like, or the HD camera, or I don't know, did something. Okay, so we only have 3 Sennelier colors, but we're going to work with what we have, and let's see about creating a little painting. And if you guys want to ask questions, you can. I'm going to start with our lightest color, our yellow. If you have friends who have, you know, watercolor paints, maybe they have a different brand than you, you can get together and you could do sample swatches and test blending with their paints. Get together and let them use your paints, you use their paints. I'm going to mix up some orange using the colors that I have. Hello. Hi, everybody who's coming in. If you're from YouTube, we had like some major problems over on YouTube. I don't know if it's my webcam or my computer or YouTube or Google. I don't know. Okay, and then we're gonna add the red. We were also gifted with some Zen watercolor brushes from, Zen watercolor brushes from Royal and Lang Nickel. I'll have to make sure I thank Dee Dee for that. I have a couple of those really large round watercolor palettes. I really love them, especially when I'm not doing stuff on camera, and or when we're having parties. They're fabulous. They're huge, and they're on a Lazy Susan, so they twirl around. So now we're going to mix up some green with the colors. We're working on Sennelier, and I only have 3 colors. It's fabulous. Robax palettes. They make a couple of different versions. They're wonderful. They're not inexpensive, but they're nice. I have 1 for watercolor and 1 for gouache. And I don't know about you guys, my picture on my iPad is sideways. You know, none of these live broadcasting things are perfect, I guess. I didn't want to, like, not do Watercolor Wednesday because my webcam was acting up, so I came on to Periscope. Thank you. I've done a few of these live broadcasts now with the webcam, so I don't know, can't imagine it was the webcam, but I don't know, I guess I'll have to look into it later. Michelle, I wish you were closer. Yay. All right, I'm gonna mix up some purple. Oh, I guess the purple is the one I didn't add to the other. So you can see that was only with three colors. They blend nicely on the both on the palette and on the paper. The Sennelier are made with honey as a binder instead of gum arabic, which was in a lot of others. So they're very different that way. It was mentioned over on YouTube that if you are using the Sennelier or paints with honey, that it was rumored that you know, you kind of attract bees. If you're working inside, it's fine because of the honey. I don't know if that's true or not. I only have the three paints that are the three colors from Sennelier that are made with honey. So, and I don't take them outside. This is my normal travel palette, and this is a mixture of Daniel Smith and Koi. And so let's do a little Koi sample. And I'll see, I had so many technical issues, it dried out a little bit. Where's my squirt bottle? Yeah, I'm not a big bee fan. They're good for the environment, but yeah. All right. And I was saying over on YouTube, now I'm feeling like I have to repeat myself because we're basically starting all over again. Okay, new card installed. I don't know, you guys. I'm just, this morning is bad. All right, so as I was saying, I already had one of these Royal and Langnickel Zen brushes, but when they sent me a bunch of paints, they sent me a bunch more brushes. So we're using the number 8 Royal and Langnickel Zen watercolor brush. I really like these brushes, and they're not super expensive. And I'm not saying that because they sent me brushes. I'm saying that because I already owned one before they sent me brushes. I'm glad to get more. It has the occasional like stray funky hair. But I noticed that with the other one too, and then once I used it a little bit, then there was no more stray hair, so I don't know. Probably just because it's an inexpensive brush. I just wrote and asked. I told them what I was doing. I sent them all of my social media and YouTube channel, blog channel information, my website, all that stuff, and said that we were doing these paint swatch reviews. And then maybe, and then they sent me a selection of things to try, including their paints, which we will work with in an upcoming episode. And if I keep having issues with the HD camera, the episode may be here on Periscope. I do flip back and forth, but all of these episodes I do put onto YouTube. And I'm filming with my HD camera while we're doing this, which is why I put the new card in it, so that I have film footage to get over there. Let's see, green. So these are the Koi paints, and they're, you know, they're pigmented a little differently. They're a little more chalky, I think, in my opinion. But, you know, when I'm just out and about doing a quick little watercolor painting or working in one of my journals, I think the Koi are fine. They are student grade. They are sort of, they do have some light fastness. They don't have as many colors, and their little cakes are not refillable from, you know, a tube. They have some tubes, but they don't have all the colors in a tube, which kind of bugs me. Oh, we lost some viewers. I'm surprised I have any viewers. I'm surprised anybody is here watching with all the issues I've had this morning. Hello from Slovenia. Thank you. Yeah, these are the Koi. And I like the Koi. And they do make a plastic travel palette. I understand the new one has 30 colors in it. I totally forgot to do the doors. Look at that. Yeah. Now I really need a deep breath and, like, I don't know, a cup of tea or something. Holy cow. I'm going to be spending the rest of the afternoon, instead of arting, working on the computer, trying to figure out what's wrong with the webcam and if it's me or if it's the internet or what. All right, so there's three little house paintings. And I like them all. They're nice. Even the sennelier. I mean, I didn't have as many colors to work with, but I know, right? I don't know. I don't know. So I love that. So then let's do some, the next would be color blending experiments. So for this, I already pre-drew these color wheels on here. And first we'll do the Grumbacher. Now for this, we only need three colors of paint. And we're gonna do, yeah, I did too. I saw the same video by Julie and it looked interesting. So I'm gonna do the bismuth yellow. Then I'm going to skip three and I'm going to do the true red. And skip three and then do the blue, which is Prussian blue. This is a good exercise to do with any paints, watercolor, acrylic, and any three colors. I got my set of Koi paints at Hobby Lobby. They carry Koi at Hobby Lobby. The Grumbacher paints were sent, these were sent to me. I own some, they're right here. I already owned these. And the Sennelier were sent to me. Okay, so the first thing you do when you do this exercise, let's put this extra one somewhere where it's not gonna get icked up. Okay, so we're gonna take our yellow and we're gonna put the pure pigment in this triangle on our color wheel. Then we're going to take our red and we're going to do the same thing with the red. These are the Grumbacher paints. Isn't that a nice bright red? And then we're going to do the blue. And it's fun to do this kind of exercise and switch up which yellow, which red, and which blue that you use. You'll get completely different results depending on the color. Okay, now we're going to need our plate here. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to mix some of the red and some of the yellow. Well, we're losing people fast. And 50-50 mix goes here. Then we're going to add some more yellow to part of that. And then we're going to add some more red to part of that. And with just those two colors, you get three different colors. I'm going to actually, that's a really red. I'm going to actually, there's no right or wrong way to do this. And I'm a little off now because we had problems. Yeah, this is a basic test that you do when you're, you know, in art school. That's still a little red for me, but that's okay. You get the idea. And then we'll do the red and blue. And this is good, you know, when you're at a loss for inspiration especially, get out your paints, make a color wheel, and just do some blending and some playing with your supplies. Now this is Prussian blue, which in my opinion is a little turquoisey, so we're going to get different results than what I'm used to getting. So I'm going to add more red to part of it. And I'm trying to take deep breaths and calm down and remember to leave some space between your colors or they'll start to bleed together like these are a little bit because I messed it up. All right. Add some more blue to the purple. Put that here. And depending on how much of the blue or how much of the red you put in your mix, you're going to get three or four or more completely different colors. So this is a really great experiment or practice thing to do. So now we're going to do yellow and blue. And like I said before over on YouTube, this is kind of a chalky yellow, like it has like Chinese white or something in it. So we're going to get, and that we have the Prussian blue, which is already kind of a turquoisey color, so we're getting a different blue than I'm used to. Or green, sorry. So we have that. Now let's get some yellow and make it more yellow. And then let's get some more blue and make it more blue. Prussian blue, yeah, it's a good name. All right, so we have that. Grab a baby wipe. No, wipe. Normally I wouldn't just wipe all this watercolor paint off of my palette. I would use it on something, but not this morning. Okay. So now let's do the Sennelier. Sennelier is a French paint brand. Let's do what is the yellow is just called yellow light. Skip three, and then we have it's I don't know, it's not super red, but it's called Opera Rose. And then skip three and Scenario, I don't know how to pronounce it. Blue. It's a blue. That color blue. All right. And when you're buying watercolor and you're wanting to upgrade your watercolor palette or you wanted to start playing with watercolor, you really don't need more than a yellow, a red, and a blue. And when I started collecting my watercolor paints, I just did it one or two tubes at a time. When I switched to tubes. Before that, I always had cake sets. So there's our yellow. Here's our rose. It's very bright pink. Reminds me of the Daniel Smith opera pink. And this is our blue. That was too dry of a spot there. So this is the pure pigment of the color. And this is, you can tell by the fact that it just covered up the S on the color name, how opaque this color is. Let's see if we can lift that a little bit. Yep, there we go. Okay, now we'll start mixing. So we're going to take some of our yellow, some of our pink, mix them together. It is a lot. This is, it's a different color. It's what I have. It's what they sent me, but it's a different color. But it's very well pigmented for the color that it is. So we're going to add a little more yellow to it. And put that here. And then a little bit more of the pink to it. Put that here. I will, of course, scan all of these pictures and images from today's broadcast and put them over on my website, GinaBaerns.com. There's a Watercolor Wednesday page over there. And I will load this video to YouTube. Which I now have to do and delete all the mistake videos over on YouTube. That there's now a bunch of like videos with no sound, videos with bad picture. I might leave up the one where we were on for a few minutes. It was not great, but it wasn't horrible. Isn't that a pretty color purple with that rose color and this other blue? So that's why you should really try doing this with, you know, different colors in your palette than just the standard blue and yellow and red. You know, pick a pink and a turquoise and maybe a gold and yellow and see what you get. Okay, and then now let's add more pink. And that's just three colors of Sennelier paint. And as we found out earlier over on YouTube, they're between the Sennelier and Grumbacher, both are between like $7 and $15, $18-ish a tube, depending on the color that you get. That's a nice green, too. I almost added orange to my green. You know what happens when you do that, right? It's gonna get brown. Okay. This is a pretty limey green. That's nice. Alright. And we'll add more blue to it. So those are pretty. So let's do the... All right. So first let's put the names. As I said before, one of my problems with koi is that they're not refillable from tubes. They have some tubes, but not all of the colors in tubes, which I don't like that. So I just use it for travel, and when these little pans get empty, then I will refill them with something else. They weren't originally in this pan. The koi palette comes, it's a plastic palette. I repotted them into this with some Daniel Smith paints, and this is what I take when I go on vacation. And here is a better view of it. It's a small metal, standard metal artist travel watercolor palette. And I took the insert in the middle out that comes with it. They come with inserts that are like this, that are sized to fit the palette. I took that out because you could only get 12 colors in that, and taking it out allowed me to get 21 colors in. All right, and then our red. Now these koi are pigmented nicely. Are they the same as the artist grade? No. But for just, you know, working in your mixed media journal or doing like a greeting card, something like that, I think they're fine. They do have some light fastness. But they're a student grade paint. They're in that category. And they blend okay, but I always seem to have a little more trouble blending them than I do other paints. And I don't know if it's just because they're like chalkier or because they're student grade paints, probably. They're just not pigmented the same as an artist grade paint. Let's add some more red to that. If you guys have any questions, let me know. This is really good practice. You can definitely do this with acrylic paints. Probably like water-soluble crayons, that sort of thing. You can do this with lots of different mediums, and it's a good idea because it's good practice to learn what your mediums will and won't do. Yeah, the kois are nice. There's nothing, I like the koi, and it's very affordable, and they have them at Hobby Lobby, and you can get a set with a coupon. So they're budget friendly for those of us who are art supply poor. And again, this is just three colors. I'm only, you know, they have the new set, like I said before, that has 30 in it, which is wonderful. We all just heard about that from Julie. They found Bowser over on YouTube. And, but this is just a few of their colors out of the 24 set. I kept my favorite colors, put them in my travel set, and I gave the rest away. So that's the koi. So there's our three brands that we're working on this morning. Let's see, maybe if we go this way. I'm looking at how it is in the camera on the phone. There we go. So those are the three we did this morning. Now I do have one other color blending exercise that I usually do with the paints. And then we add them all into our book, which I'll show you guys in a minute. So I have this one, which is a similar, it's still a blending exercise. It's just it's a little different. So you're still only using three colors, red, yellow, and blue. You want to document the colors that you're using and the brand. And if you can get together with some of your friends who have other brands of paint than you, And then you guys can all do this with the different brands and like make a decision about maybe what colors and what brands that you want to add to your collection. I'm usually a little more upbeat about Watercolor Wednesday and doing our test swatches, but with all the technical issues this morning, I'm like totally, I don't know, I'm off. I don't know what else to say about it. I keep saying that. Aye, aye, aye. All right. If I can get the YouTube thing working later, I will come on in a little while and do a vlog if I can get it working. Let's see. Let's grab a brush. So underneath this square, oh, there was some blue on the brush. Whoops. Let's get that lifted. Okay. Yay. I'm so glad, Mr. Ron. Over on YouTube was nothing but problems, but we're broadcasting with my phone instead of my webcam, so I'm not sure if it's the webcam or the internet connection. No idea. All right. So here, it's probably not the internet connection because my phone is broadcasting over the house Wi-Fi, so it's probably not that. It's probably something else. All right, so in this square, again, you'll put the true color. Right? Where the squares meet, you'll put the true color. The yellow is not super exciting. Because it's just three yellow squares. Okay. Now, for the red, we're going to put the true red here. Isn't that a nice, dark, luscious red? And look, I'm filling the other square and I haven't even picked up any more paint. And then where these two lines meet, there'll be more of the true red. And look, I filled up three squares and I didn't even pick up any more paint. Look at that. That's nicely pigmented paint. All right. Now, these two will be mixtures of red and yellow. This one that's closer to the red is going to be more red, and this one that's closer to the yellow, I'm going to make more yellow. It's very bad. This is the Grumbacher. This is their artist brand. They do have Academy Acrylics, which is a student grade. This is their artist grade paint. So this first mixture is going to be more red, then orange. Or then yellow, I should say. And then this next, and then I'm going to add more yellow to it. And I'm going to put that color here. I should add more yellow to that. It's not different enough for me. That's better. Okay, I'm going to do that with the blue. So we're going to put the blue here. Look at this blue. And here. So this is the Prussian blue. It's pretty dark. And it lifts some of it. There we go. I like to use Prussian blue when I do seascapes. I like it for my ocean color. Now the blue, when you do the blue, I just eyeball it. I just eyeball it. So here is where the blue is meeting the red. Oh, that's purple though. Oops. Let's pick up the right color. Let's move that a little bit. All right, blue. All right, and red. Okay, so on this side, I'm gonna do it where it's more red, and on this side, I'm gonna do it where it's more blue. And I'm gonna add water to it so you can really like get an idea for the color. In its lighter form, and then I'm going to add some more blue to it. I do the same thing. Now, because you're mixing a red with a Prussian blue, which I think has like a, seems to have like a little bit of yellow or something in it, you get more of gray or purpley colors. All right, so we're going to do the same thing with the yellow. So we'll take our blue and our yellow. And this one's going to be more yellow. And I'm still of the opinion that that bismuth yellow, it's an opaque color. Like it has like Chinese white or something in it. Then we're going to add some more blue to it up here. And if you want this information on all these color blending exercises and comparisons so that you can make an educated guess about what you can buy, that's why I download them on my website on the Watercolor Wednesday page, so that you guys can print them and download them and put them in a book that way. I do encourage you to do these exercises yourself, though. Okay, now we're going to do the Sennelier. And as part of my reference book, I also, at the back, off camera, I put in like a chart of all the colors I own. So if I do want to add to my collection of watercolor paints, I know which ones I've already got so I don't buy it again. But that's not the primary purpose of this book. It's to do these experiments with and to compare the paint brands. Okay. So now we're going to do yellow. Okay, and then red, or it's not really red, it's opera rose. Yeah, I like the Sennelier yellow. It's called Yellow Light. It's a very nice yellow. It's nicely pigmented, and it's not chalky at all. It's very clear and lemony, and I do like that. And that, again, could just be the difference between the pigments and the two paints. It is possible Grumbacher has a color that's more similar to this. This is just what they sent me. And they sent me these samples because I wrote and asked for them. So I wouldn't rule them out, but I would look for a different yellow if I was going to create a palette of Grumbacher paints. Okay, so these are the three Sennelier colors that they sent me in a sample pack. Now we're going to do the same exercise that we did before on the other square after we clean up our palette. Okay, so now we're going to take our yellow and our rose. And we'll mix one up together that's more rosy. And then we'll take that and put some more yellow in it. I want to just put more yellow in that. Yeah, I would look for something that's more, I don't know, different yellow in the Grumbacher. Okay. And then now we're going to do the blue. Thank you, Muhammad. And we will do blue. Yeah, I do have multiple plates, but I'm so discombobulated, Ron, this morning from the trying to start this first on YouTube and then having to switch and camera issues and all the other craziness that went on this morning. I'm very discombobulated, so we're just going to do the baby wipe thing. That works. All right, and so here is the rose. We're going to mix these together, and we already discovered from the other exercise that this blue and this opera rose make a really pretty purple. So we're going to do the one that's more blue here. And then I'm going to add more of the rose to it and put that here. We'll give our plate a turn, and we will start again with our blue, and then we will add in some yellow, and I know, right? These are the Saint Hélier. They're very well pigmented. They're beautiful colored paints. Their binder is honey, so they stay sticky. They don't completely dry out. I will do some kind of summary of my opinion, probably both on video and in writing. But the truth is, I like all paints, all watercolor paints. They all have their uses, and depending on what your budget is going to be a huge factor in which one you pick and what you're doing with it. So if you're just playing around in your art journals and you're just making tags, making greeting cards, maybe you don't want to spend a lot of money on Schmincke watercolor paints or something like that. So maybe then Koi is fine, or the new Prima ones, or Grumbacher's, but the Academy acrylics. It does, yeah, this very much, look at this, very spring and Easter time. All right, let's do the koi really quick. all of these recordings where I've been working on these paints, paint swatches, are all up on YouTube. And you can see them on my YouTube channel. And if you just search for my name on YouTube, you'll find me. if you search for my name, you're going to find me all over the place. Okay, so lemon yellow. We were using Crimson Lake. And like I said before, whatever brand you have, if you only have one brand, I encourage you to at least do these color blending exercises. And for each one of these squares, pick a different yellow, a different red, and a different blue, and see what colors you get. Because you're going to get vastly different colors depending on what pigments you choose to use. You're going to get different, completely different blends. And if you're having a day where inspiration is just not there for you, just break out a piece of paper and do some color blending. Okay. And that's good. I saw that. You're gonna do this. I think that's a fabulous idea. Get together with some of your friends and have an arty party, and everybody bring, you know, what color of watercolor paints, or what brand of watercolor paints they have, or if you're doing it with acrylic paints, have them bring their acrylic paints, and everybody switch, switch paints with each other around the table, and everybody do these exercises with those brands of paints. The Van Gogh are okay, but they're a student grade paint, in my opinion. They're not as nicely pigmented as some of these others. Now, this is the Koi. This is definitely a student grade paint. It is not an artist grade paint. They're decently pigmented. Some of the colors are not super transparent. But for just doing, this is the, like I said, this is the one I take with me when I'm like going out of town. It has a few Daniel Smith colors in it, which I love. And it has the koi in it because I had them and I thought, you know, I wanted to use them up, but they're nice. For the student grade paint, they're decently pigmented. They have a few colors I like. I really like the purple, which we're not really using right now, but the purple is nice. But they definitely, you can just see how much more vibrant, like, the Grumbacher or Sennelier are when they're dry. But these are not bad, and they're, like I said, they're very affordable. So if you're doing art on a budget and you don't have a lot of money for, you know, Schmincke or Daniel Smith paints, there's nothing, I don't think there's anything wrong with the Koi or one of those other similar sets. Not to get started. My biggest beef with the Koi is that the little pans are not refillable from a tube. So when you run out of color, you have to like buy a whole new set if you're only out of blue. And I'm not okay with that. Now the Sennelier paints, they make tubes and pans, and their tubes are the same color as their pan, and the Schmincke is the same, way, I think. So some of those artist grade paints that they have a dry pan and a tube, they match. So now Daniel Smith doesn't have that because they don't do dry cakes. I think they used to, but they don't anymore. Okay, so now we're going to see how well these blend. So we'll put this one here. Then we'll add some more of the yellow to it. Yeah, Sennelier pans I think are more affordable than the tubes. So you might look at that if you're looking at buying something like that. And, you know, these are some of the things to think about. Why, even when I do my final summary on this, you still won't probably see me telling you which one to buy. But I'm going to give you all the ins and outs about each brand. And when you're, one of the things to think about is if you, what you're going to do with the paint. Are you going to just make cards and tags? Are you just fooling around? Or are you going to try them with the idea that you might want to actually do some serious watercoloring with them? Maybe you don't know. So I recommend not spending more money than your budget will allow, especially if you're not sure what you're going to do with the paints. Are the paints refillable from a tube? Are refills of the paints easily obtained? So that when you run out of a color like cerulean blue, are you going to be able to easily replace that and get more of it? Or is it going to be a problem because they only do the cakes like the Koi? Prima also came out with some new watercolors, and they're nicely pigmented, very comparable to the Koi, I think, in quality and color and consistency, but they don't have refills either. Now they have said that they're planning on doing them, but they don't have them yet. So that's our blue with the red, one that's more blue, one that's more red. I also hate plastic palettes, so I almost stuck my brush in the red. So if I can get a paint that already comes in a metal palette, like the Schmincke, I like that. This one here. Or if I want to buy the paint and I want to put it into a metal palette, I factor that cost in. Yes, the Sennelier are a French brand of paint. I've also been talking to an Italian paint brand whose name I can't pronounce, and they're very kind of exclusive, so I'm trying to get them to send me some samples. Hello from Russia. All right. So here are the three color blending that we've done this just now. Oops, let's turn it this way. Okay, so here is the Koi, the Grumbacher, and the Sennelier. And I'm going to show you my book. We're going to let these dry for just a second. And I'm going to show you my book as we put some of these pages back in. Okay, so this is the product review swatch book for watercolor that we've been working on over on YouTube for those of you who have not been watching this before today. And I put this together. It's got a pocket in the front with some templates for doing some of the charts. And this is the section that all of these go in. So we already did... I haven't done the Prima yet. So the Prima are coming, and maybe we'll do those next week, and you'll see, and I'll do it right underneath so you can see that I think the Koi are very comparable in colors and texture to the Prima. But they both have the same problem. They don't have refill tubes, at least not at this point. We've also already done Winsor & Newton, Van Gogh, Holbein, Coir, Schmincke, Daniel Smith, Mission Gold, and May Mary Blue. I am a big Daniel Smith fan. I love their color range. I love their paints. I love the consistency of them and everything. I also love that they're made in the USA and I can buy them easily locally. I own a Schmincke palette and I like it too. I generally don't stick to one paint brand. And my favorite palettes are ones that are mixed. Here are the sample little houses I've done. Up a little bit. There we go. This is Schmincke, Mission Gold, May Mary Blue, and Daniel Smith. Winsor & Newton, Holbein, Coir, and Van Gogh. And then let's add our new one in here. This is the new one we did. I started on this one when the YouTube thing decided to freak out. All right, and this is the color wheel page. So these are our color wheel mixes that we've done on the brands we've already been working with already. Mission Gold is a fabulous brand, by the way. I was very impressed. I had never heard of them before. A viewer asked me if I could get a hold of some to try, and I was very impressed with their paints. Very richly pigmented. And you can see how pale these Van Gogh paints are, and the Winsor & Newton ones I have for the most part I think are the student brand. I don't think a lot of them are the artist. So you can see how lessly pigmented they are than the others. Holbein, Coir. Some of the Coirs are fabulous, and you just have to, it depends on the color that you get. So let's add our new ones in here. And just look at these, how dark these are. The Sennelier are fabulous. I just don't like that they stay sticky. That's my only thing. I like my paints to dry out. Okay, now we have our blending. Thank you. This has taken, you know, a lot. And I'm, like I said before, I'm going to be scanning some of these pages and I will be putting them up onto my website so you guys can download them. But if you can do a book like this for yourself, that's the best way. Okay, and then here we have different, when I first started Watercolor Wednesdays, we did some of these technique cards where we push saran wrap into the watercolor and let it dry. We scratched into it. We did put it over modeling paste and things like that. So I took those little cards and I put them into pockets in here. And we may be doing more of this. And Blue Crafty 74, who is Lady Blue Studios over on YouTube. Michelle, if you want to throw up your YouTube channel link, she's a friend of mine, and she's doing a product review source book only for pens and markers. You can do this kind of source book for anything, and she has some similar categories, but some that are completely different because they go better with that medium. And then in the back, I have sort of an inventory bunch of inventory sheets. So if I have this out with me, or I know I'm going to go ordering or buying more watercolor paint to try different things, I can look at what I already have. I don't buy duplicates. But that's not the primary use for this book. I am on YouTube, and all of these episodes, no matter where they were broadcasted, are on YouTube. If you search for my name, just put my name in Google. I'm going to come up everywhere. This is my channel name, Gina B. Ahrens. And there's a Watercolor Wednesday page on my website. This is my website, and it has free downloads, links to manufacturers, and things like that. I will be updating it later today after I get the video now downloaded from the HD camera and try to figure out what is wrong with the webcam. I try to be on here every Wednesday morning at 10 a.m. This morning that didn't work out quite well. I've been on YouTube. I stopped doing Periscope because YouTube is more convenient. But if we continue to have technical difficulties, I may be back on Periscope. But I'll be here somewhere. And we always announce it on social media. So if you're on my Facebook or Google Plus or Twitter, then I always announce where I'm going to be and when I'm going to be on live on social media. So follow me on Facebook. Join my Facebook group. The link for that is here. Follow me on Twitter. Like I said, if you just put my name in, put this in, you're going to find me. Google Plus. I announce it all over the place, as many places as I can think of. And if I'm going to continue to have problems with YouTube, I'll be simulcasting with Periscope. So if YouTube crashes, I'll still be on with Periscope. And that may be what I continue to do. All right, that's it, everybody. I'm going to go try to figure out what's up with my equipment, and I will talk to you later. Don't forget the most important thing. Have a great day and do something nice for yourself, because you deserve it, like play with your paints. All right, I'll see you all later. Bye.